Hey Toronto family, and by extension the world, it's your girl LILBITTS, and it is my pleasure to bring to you my newest single, Remember Me.
G987FM, the way we groove, this is the Enforcas, and we have on the air one of the Caribbean sexy soca divas, hailing from the beautiful Twin Isle Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, musician, actress, songwriter, costume designer, LILBITTS. Welcome back to the Soca Groove.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. How's it going?
Good. How's Toronto?
Yeah, good. It's getting a little colder, but we're surviving.
Still my favorite place outside of Trinidad.
Nice.
Yeah.
So for the benefit of our listeners, can you explain how you got started as a soca artist?
I used to do calypso. Yes. And from calypso, I decided that I wanted to convert to soca when I was about 17.
Yeah.
And it so happened that Colonel Roberts went to school with me. Wow. He was like 4 years in front of me.
Okay.
And he and my sister were best friends because my sister went to the same school as me.
Yeah.
And she said, "You gotta write a song for my sister. I need to write a song for my sister." And he wrote "Spin Your Towel." I did that in the junior soca mona competition.
Yeah.
And he did a couple of songs, and then after, in my third year of doing soca, I did "In My Country," which I wrote myself.
Nice.
With Bungie Garland, my career took off. Kitch wrote more songs for me. I wrote more songs for myself. My brother wrote songs for me.
Yeah.
And I'm still here.
Excellent. All right. So now you have a new project out right now, Remember Me. Can you explain to us how that project came together?
So during the carnival season, I recorded this song. Yeah. I was looking for material because I think it's very important for artists to, you know, stack up your material, have songs there.
Yes.
And initially we were supposed to release it after carnival.
Yeah.
Then COVID happened.
Yes.
Which we didn't expect. This track was produced by Jelani Pops Shaw.
Mm-hmm.
He also did Road for Marshall Montano.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. And it was co-produced by Advocate Productions, written by Teddy Rhymes from Grenada.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Excellent. Cool. Great team. And we like the project. Definitely a great song. Can you talk to us about the visuals and how that came together? You did a good video for that.
So because it is COVID.
Yes.
I was looking for like an affordable way to do a video.
Yes.
And also for it to be able to go with the concept of the song.
Yeah.
So when I think about remembering somebody, I think memories, I think pictures.
Yeah.
So I said, why not take the pictures, like do a photo shoot and the video shoot and put it in one and let the photo shoot be the actual concept of the video.
Makes sense.
Myself, Space Boy, the stylist, he's the guy who's been styling me all of carnival and having me looking fabulous. He styled me for the entire video.
Yeah.
And yeah, we just wanted all kind of different looks that people, when they see it, they would be like, wow. And pretty much we got a response. Yeah, they will remember me because they look so absolutely amazing.
Yeah.
Based on the video. And the photography was really nice as well. Big up Romano Francois of We Up Films who did the video. And Hey Choppy actually edited the video.
Oh, nice. Okay.
He's a writer and an artist. He's actually an excellent videographer and editor.
Wow.
So big up Hey Choppy as well.
Yes. Excellent. So what advice would you give to young artists coming into the soca industry?
Just be yourself and trust your vibe.
Yes.
I was a bit skeptical, obviously, releasing a song during COVID.
Yeah.
But I felt as if like we needed that.
Yes.
Because I know a lot of my fellow artists are very depressed and everybody's down in the dumps because all the carnivals were canceled through the year. And then you got the news that Trinidad's carnival was not going to be at all.
Yes.
So people were like, oh my God. And you know, it really puts in a very bad headspace. And I was like, yo, this is the perfect time to drop this song.
Yes.
Something to go, you know, a beat and happy and just, you know, and it's a nice mixture of, you know, like a little pop, but it's still soca and just something to make people, you know, smile. At it, and everybody enjoyed the video. They're like, oh my God, I love the visuals. And I was like, okay, I did it. And my birthday was Saturday going.
Yes.
So it worked out perfectly that I could do it for my birthday and people really, really, really enjoyed it.
Excellent. Well, we appreciate your time so much, LILBITTS. If you could remind our listeners how they could follow you on social media.
I am on all social media handles. Yeah. You can check me out on Facebook, Instagram. My page is official LILBITTS on both Facebook and Instagram. And you could also check me out on Twitter. It's LILBITTS as well. And I'm always online. You could always, don't be up in the DMs. Too much, right? You could put nice little comments underneath the videos, individuals. I don't mind.
Yeah.
But you could DM me, but you know, be respectful.
Right.
Respectful. Yes. I don't mind that at all. But yeah, and be sure to buy, download, and stream music. This is the one way that people can really support artists right now.
Absolutely. Yes. Thanks so much.
No problem.
All right. You take care.
Thank you. Bye. Bye.